I'm running for president because we're facing a crisis that threatens everything we stand for. As a skinny kid with Coke bottle glasses and a funny last name, I've stood up.
Well, he said it, not me. Former Governor John Hickenlooper has officially announced his run for president in the 2020 election. It was breaking news here on the Fox 31 Morning News on Monday, and now he's here in Colorado in the studio to talk about this. We've got political reporter Joe St. George here to talk with you as well. So first of all, and this was the first thing I just said to you a couple of minutes ago, it's a scary proposition for any Democrat to walk in the room and see 13, 14 other Democrats already running for president. Why throw your hat in this crowded ring?
Well, I look at this as, I believe that the country's in a crisis, a national crisis, and it's a crisis of division, right? I don't think we've been this divided since the Civil War. And if you look at what we've done in Colorado and what I've been able to do with my team, we've been able to bring people together and get things done, right, to create progress. And whether you look at healthcare, where we are, we're almost 100% coverage in universal coverage in Colorado for healthcare. Look at some of the climate change, right? We were able to get the environmental community and the oil and gas industry to create comprehensive methane regulations. It's the equivalent of taking 220 or 320,000 cars a year off the roads, and the oil and gas industry is paying for it. That's being rolled out nationally as national policy in Canada. Each of these things are places where the people kind of hated each other. The oil and gas industry and the environmental community, right. It's like the Hatfields and the McCoys.
Contentious.
But we got stuff done, right? And that's what, I think that's what the country needs right now.
But you're not for at least 100% of the Green New Deal, right? You're not for 100% of Medicare for all. You told me in November that you'd still be weary and advise other states to hold off on legalizing marijuana. Are you progressive enough? You're seeing the crowd. You're seeing the crowds Bernie Sanders is getting so far in this race. Are you worried you're not left enough?
No. I mean, I'm who I am, and I look at each of these issues where Medicare for all. Is Medicare for all really the right thing? Probably.
Bernie Sanders will say so.
The last time I checked, there are 100 million people in this country that have health coverage through their workplace, right, with private insurance companies, and are happy with it, right? Are we going to force them to give up what they have that they're satisfied with? And it's very similar to the German, that part of our system is similar to the German system. And, I think we should pull back a bit and say, listen, don't we all care about everyone having a medical home, someone who you can get a checkup once a year from? And don't we really want to get to some sort of universal coverage? Once we get to that agreement, then we can say, all right, what are the best practices from Medicare? It's probably not Medicare for all. It's probably Medicare Advantage, I think, offers better solutions. In other words, it rewards medical practitioners for keeping people healthy much more successfully. That kind of stuff really matters.
So the mom or dad sitting in Highlands Ranch, a lot of people out there thinking to themselves, you know what? Maybe it's divisive. That's why so many Democrats are jumping in the ring. But maybe it's not so bad. The economy is not bad. A lot of people are relatively happy with the way things are right now. So why do they need change? Why do they need someone to come in and fix things, which is what a lot of Democrats, yourself included, are kind of saying is needed?
I think this crisis of division has the potential to do more damage than we can even imagine. Forget about healthcare for a moment.
Yeah.
Go on to climate change. Most scientists believe that we're getting to the point where the consequences of inaction will become irreversible. That's really serious. Look at the jobs. Sure, the economy is, the unemployment's low.
Well, that's the thing, as I'm saying, is a lot of people that live here in Colorado, they don't care what's happening in D.C., how divided it is. They just care that their 401k is doing all right and they've got a job. That's the truth.
But most of them like to get a job that pays them a little better.
That's true.
An upward pathway for a real career. If you look at, 65-70% of our kids, and this has been true for 30 years, are never going to graduate from college. We pulled back all of our training.
Yeah.
Automation and artificial intelligence, you think the disruption in the workplace in the 80s and the 90s with all the outsourcing and automation back then, if you think that was bad, it's going to be 10 times worse in the next 5 to 10 years. And we're not doing anything about it. We have to be able to train kids. And in Colorado, we have a platform by which we'll be able to do this. But train kids of all ages, so if they're going to lose their profession, we can get them the skills they need so they can actually get the new jobs that are emerging and are actually higher paying than the jobs they have. have now.
Real quick, you know live TV goes by fast, so we only have a few more seconds with you. It seems like you're putting all your eggs in one basket or at least two baskets, right? Iowa and New Hampshire.
Yeah.
Where are you going to have to finish come Iowa caucus night, come New Hampshire primary night to keep your campaign going? Top five finish?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I think in Iowa, I want to win Iowa, and I want to be in the top two in New Hampshire. And
it'd be over if you're not up near the top.
I don't think it'd be, if I'm not near the top, yeah, I think it'd be very difficult for someone like me if I can't perform in Iowa and New Hampshire. I mean, that's part of what we're trying to take this Colorado model. This whole thing Thursday, we're doing this big celebration.
Yeah.
I don't know if they told you, but that we're going to have Nathaniel Rateliff and the Night Sweats is going to come out as kind of really be a send-off for my campaign, a launch, as it were. But it's also going to be a celebration of all the great stuff that has happened and is happening in Colorado. Nathaniel Rateliff and the Night Sweats are going to play. Such, who's one of our great local performers, is going to play. I mean, just a few songs.
Are you going to play?
I might play a little bit.
It's standard presidential.
Sounds like a challenge to me.
Yeah.
Well, good to have you. Thank you for taking time. We look forward to, of course, continuing this conversation. Former Governor Hickenlooper joining us live here on the Morning News to talk about his race for the president, if you will, to get that Democratic nomination. We appreciate you taking the time.
You bet. Thank you.
All right, let's get over to a time-saver traffic alert.
Yeah, a bit of a good news. Good stuff, you guys, by the way. But a bit of a good news with this traffic alert for you guys. You see southbound I-25. Last time we showed you, it was a parking lot as you made your way through downtown Denver. We were talking 30-plus minutes just to make